Hey, Chris Menard here. Great Excel video. Came from one of my YouTube subscribers. They wanted to highlight every other row. So here are three different options for doing that. We'll end up with my favorite method, conditional formatting. But let's dive in right now to this video. Method one, my least favorite, and I encourage you not to do this, but I know people do use this method. Come in here, I'm holding down the control key. I'm gonna just do one more to keep this simple. And you go and you click on the paint can and highlight. Horrible method, because if you start sorting, it'll get messed up. I did an undo, I'm back here. Method two, just make it a table. Right now it's a range. Control T, or on the home tab, format as a table. I'm going to do Control T. Actually, I'm okay with this method. I love tables in Excel. And if you don't like the way it looks, this is what's cool about this method. It's so easy to change it to a different format. By the way, if I do this method, I'm going to go and sort it. Now the sorting will be correct. I'm going to sort it by the invoice amount. Actually, let's just use the filter arrow. Let's go largest to smallest. You can see that it's still every other row is selected. Method three, because I do use the table method a lot, but here we go with method three. It gives you the most flexibility. Conditional formatting. So before I do the conditional formatting, I need to explain two Excel functions to you, and they're really simple. You should know them anyway. One is the row function, equals row, open print. All the row function does is tells you what row you're in. It doesn't do anything else. The other function is the MOD function, the number 7 and the number 2. If I divide 7 by 2, it goes 3 times, the remainder is 1. So equals MOD. There are two arguments to this function. The number, comma, not a divide sign. What is your divisor? The number 2. 7 divided by 2 again is 3 with 1 remainder, and that is what I get. If I change this to 3, I'm going to get 1, but if I change it to 4, I should get 3. Perfect. And 5, I'll get 2. So there is your MOD function. So now that you know those two functions, we're going to go write a couple conditional formatting rules. Conditional formatting, the rules never change. Select what you want to apply conditional formatting to. So I started in cell A2 and went to the bottom. I did not pick up my header row. Conditional formatting, new rule. Use a formula. Equals MOD. Remember, MOD had two arguments, but the first argument is going to be the row function. So open parenth, R-O-W, open and close parenth. I started in A2, which is row 2, comma, 2 divided by 2 is 1, but the remainder is 0. I just closed it, equals 0. Format, fill tab, I'm going to use yellow, pick a color, I don't care. Row 2, 4, 6 should have a yellow background when I hit OK, and they do. The reason I like conditional formatting, I love the table too, but sometimes I come to conditional formatting, I'm going to go hit manage rules and edit that rule. Well, maybe I, instead of having the even rows, I want the odd. So I changed it to equals 1. When I hit OK, I'm just going to hit apply over here so you can see it. I don't have to close this box. It should go 3, 5, 7 with yellow. And it did. Cool tip. And then again, edit rule. I don't care about every other row. I want every fifth row. My header row is in row 1. So row 6 divided by 5 gives me 1 remaining. So I should get row 6, 11, 16, 21. When I hit OK and hit apply, edit rule, what do I have wrong? Sorry, divided by 5. That's why you check this stuff. There you go, 6, 11, 16, there's the function again. You can keep tweaking that function to do whatever range you want on the rows. Cool feature. I appreciate your time. Let me know if you have any comments or suggestions down in the comment section. Hope you have a great day. Feel free to subscribe and ring the bell. Thank you.